We've got our camera with a couple of baits on it, dropping down 150 metres to see what's down there. Oh, what are they?
Well, we're about to find out.
It's not even a bait on there. Something's biting the sinker. Something got a good hold of that, boy. Now, this contraption here, one of my favourite devices that I devised a little while ago, is to see what's down there. And at the moment, we're sitting in 109 metres of water. And well, there could be all sorts down there. So we're going to send the camera down with a couple of bits of squid on it. And I think the guys might be dropping a jig at the same time. Tell us what's down there, little camera. Okay, down, down, down she goes. Yeah, getting hit. Oh, what is it? What is that? We're gonna fire. As long as the camera doesn't get wasted and we get it back. Getting hit. Something got a good hold of that, boy. It's still going too. Come on, get it back and eat it. Oh, hopefully that footage is, oh, look at it go. Oh, it's still, it won't let go. We might have him on, mate. Might got tangled up in it. Please be still going. Yes, it's still rolling. Yeah, boy. So we've been using this homemade deep drop camera along with my homemade tow cameras for a long time now. And here's some stuff of one of the early deep drop cameras. And this time, what we're trying to do is see how kingfish react to jigs in the deep. But we also learned a lot about what your marks on your sounder actually are. Okay, stand by. I'm gonna drop this down, our lure cam, to see exactly what's down there. I'm marking some good sign, and we'll see what we can see. Okay, now that's at about 20 meters, 25, and it's at that depth I can see on the sounder there, sort of a scattered layer that could be trevally. Then it looks like it's going through pink mau mau, and that's below these pink mau mau, as it gets a little bit deeper, what looks like to be kingfish. So I'll just let it get down there through those kingfish, and then I'm gonna crank it back up. And that should be racing up, and if it gets the attention of that mob of kingfish, they should really be swarming up all over that. It's the speed of the jig. That's what this electric reel can do. It can really crank it in, and it'll get them chasing it. And it's amazing just how fast kingfish are. While that is going flat out, really cracking that jig up, a kingy could really catch that quite easily. And it's really a good lesson, if we've got some footage of it there, just how fast a kingy can swim. You'll never outwind one. Well, this time on our lure cam, I'm putting a bait into the water. So rather than lure cam, it has become bait cam, and we're gonna drop that down and just see what's going on down there. Get ready, Mandy, there's some kingy marks here. I've set my camera with the bait attached at the same depth as the kingfish sign on my Fruno sounder. Well, Mandy has dropped a jig all the way to the bottom to wind it back up through. Now the kingfish here are taking a look at the live bait, but they're not eating it. And you can see here a kingfish races out of shot as it's noticed Mandy's jig coming past. That's a girl. So it was the speed and action of the jig that coerced the bite from the kingfish. And now it's the erratic vibrations being put out from the hooked fish that has triggered the other fish into a feeding frenzy. The most common multiple hookup theory is that the fish have come on the bite, but it could be that the first hooked fish triggers the others to bite. The lesson here is to mix up your offerings. Use jigs, baits, live baits, any technique you can, because it only takes one to work, then this could trigger the rest of the fish that are down there to start feeding. Okay, now we're not gonna muck around with this one.
Okay.
Mainly because I wanna get my lure cam back down. Beautiful fish, say bye-bye.
See you, matey.
Hey, and you're away again.
Marco.
We're chasing the bait up.
I bet he's after that camera.
Jump in the boat, bro, keep your eye on him. This time of the year we've been cold, the Marco's a lot to be bigger.
Clear.
You can see it?
Yeah, clear.
It's clear now, is it? Sweet.
Woohoo!
And that's been smoked off. Yeah.
Right. Here we go. See what's down there.
How deep are we, mate?
Still the same. We're 118 here.
Good. I reckon we can handle 118. And down, down. Down she goes. What she'll see?
Don't know.
See our camera going down the bottom there. We've got some hooker on the bottom there, so not too far away, mate. And we'll see what's down there first hand. Well, second hand from the camera.
This time we've gone out a bit deeper with our deep drop cam. And we've got a fresh squid bait and a live bait attached. And we're hoping to record some rare footage of a hapuku or bass taking a bait.
Get a bite, get a bite.
Oh, the suspense is killing me. Never so much have I wanted to get a bite from a puka, and I don't even have a hook on. Just be interesting to see what the bottom looks like down there too. What we can learn from this footage from down deep is that the sign we often see on our sounder could be jellyfish, sediment, tiny invertebrates, or smaller fish. In this case, it's tarakihi.
Oh yep, there was a bite.
These smaller fish feeding will often attract the attention of larger fish, like this nice trumpeter.
Uh-oh. That was bite.
That was straight in the hook out of that one.
Yeah.
Oh boys, getting bites on it. Hopefully both those baits got smoked off. Oh yeah. Oh. Yep, there goes the other bait. Oh, what are they? Well, we're about to find out. Both baits gone.
Yep.
Torch is still going.
Yeah.
Camera's still rolling. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Oh, this is more exciting than actually catching one, isn't it? Once the camera gets beyond 90 metres deep, it gets quite dark, and there's a layer of sediment that sits about 15 metres up off the bottom. This is perhaps what is often visible on your depth sounder. And amongst this sediment is tarakihi, lots of them. But our big baits are far too big for their small, delicate mouths. But their tasty cousin, the much larger trumpeter, has no trouble eating the bait. As with the hapuku, that showed us that it's no slouch, coming in fast from below and inhaling the bait, and giving us a rare insight into how they feed in the deep, dark waters.
Okay, let's go again, hey guys.
Uh-oh, it's being hit. Oh, it's been hit on the way down. Probably a shark. Uh-oh, we've got to get it in. The camera's getting hit at 40 metres. Something's hitting it. Oh, hitting it again. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, something might be tangled up in it. Oh no, we don't want to lose our camera. 40 metres down. Something's on there, I think. Someone's hammering it. Only 40 metres below the surface and that stopped. The camera stopped and started getting smashed. Yep, something smashed the rig off. Woo-hoo! All will be revealed.
Well, not surprisingly, it was a Marco shark. And one thing I've learned from spending time in the water with Marco is they absolutely love the camera. Not in the sense they want to be on TV, but they're attracted to the electrical current coming from the camera, which most likely mimics the subtle electrical impulses coming from a fish or a wounded fish. And it's not just sharks. All sorts of fish will bite a camera, even when there's a fresh bait available right there to be eaten. So this tells us that the vibration or electrical current is more of a trigger than sight or taste.
Now, just while we've got our camera with a couple of baits on it dropping down 150 metres. So, you got a bite on the... All right. We're going to be getting some footage. Jeez, that's a decent bite. Hey, there's fish down here. We don't know what yet. So... Something's just gone NATO on it, and both baits are still there. And the Puka bomb's been attacked off. Loose. It's eaten the sinker. I've had sharks do this before, eh? Like, it'll be a Marco. They've just got, like, a thing for lead. Okay, now this time, with the jig on, we're just basically cranking it as fast as we can go, and the action of that jig should attract any kingies that are down there just to come racing up and have a look. And that way we're fishing the whole water column as well at speed. Oh, I think it got hit then. Oh, they're hitting it. I mean, fish don't always bite. So I guess having a camera, great way to explore an area. You don't have to wait here till bite time. You notice the moon's up in the sky, so not ideal for getting bites at the moment, but it's gonna be interesting to see. Rightio. We'll unlock this guy, see what secrets it holds, and we'll chuck some lures out, eh, Bretto, and cover some more ground.
As we continue on with our exploratory voyage, we take some time to analyse the footage brought back by our deep drop camera. And while our fishing only showed us there were kingfish, there was in fact much more than that. Some tarakihi and trumpeter came in for a look. There was pink mau mau and golden snapper, and also trevally was another amongst a whole range of desirable table species we found. And with all of this life, it's no surprise that there was also sharks lurking down deep in the dark. So I hope you've been informed or maybe even inspired by our deep dive into underwater footage and fish behaviour. We have loads more instructional video from basic tips and knots to full episodes and loads more fishing content, and it's all free. So please subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow on social. I'm Matt Watson and all of my stuff is free at ultimatefishing.tv.